Okay.
During the Apollo program, astronauts traveled to the moon, and one of the things that became very clear at the distance of the moon was that the Earth was beautiful, that we wanted to study it more, and that we wanted to be around it for a very long time. To do that, we needed vehicles to be able to let us stay in Earth orbit for longer periods of time. And so the Space Shuttle facilitated that ability. It's where we learn how to stay in space longer, study the effects of microgravity on different aspects of science, and also look at how we could live in space on a more permanent basis.
I was watching the Apollo program go on, these rockets lifting off and just going into the sky and just completely disappearing. But that moment where I watched the Apollo 11 crew land, and I asked about, should I become an astronaut? The next question that came out of my mouth was, can somebody black actually be an astronaut? This was just after the Civil Rights Act had just been passed, and so segregation had not departed from our society.
Throughout the 1960s and into the 1970s, NASA selected astronauts based on their qualifications. But those qualifications included being a man, being a test pilot, and later being a scientist. The space shuttles would have larger crews doing more diverse activities, and they needed people with that kind of experience on board the space shuttle. And so, with the selection of the class of 1978, people with different kinds of scientific backgrounds, women, people of color, began being chosen for space shuttle missions.
I wanted to be an astronaut, but as I got older, it looked like that was not going to happen. And then all of a sudden, that opportunity presented itself, and I was in the right place with the right credentials.
Sally was finishing her PhD in physics at Stanford University when she read in a student newspaper that NASA was looking for new astronauts. And for the first time, women could apply.
It was all I needed to know. That barrier's down. It's now up to me. If I don't become an astronaut, it's because of me and not because of any social barrier. And I was simply off and running.
The design of the space shuttle allowed for a much larger crew than on any previous spacecraft. That included a commander for the mission, a pilot for the space shuttle, and then any number of mission specialists and payload specialists who would actually be involved in the mission of the flight itself. Mission specialists who operated the Canada arm inside the payload bay, scientists who would conduct experiments inside Space Lab, and also payload specialists who were able to participate on behalf of the companies who sponsored their space flights.
So I had a degree in medicine and a minor in chemistry. So when NASA came along and selected people to be mission specialists, that was what they were looking for. People that had a major area, but also knew something about another area of science.
The space shuttle and its design were dramatically different from everything that had come before. It was larger, it could carry payloads inside a large bay. The shuttle could be used to deploy satellites, research equipment. Astronauts could do spacewalks outside in the payload bay, and they could stay in space for up to 2 weeks in Earth orbit.
Have you ever wanted to fly on the shuttle? What position would you want to have? Let us know in the comments section. And if you like this video, be sure to follow STEM in 30 on Facebook and Twitter, and subscribe to the National Air and Space Museum's YouTube channel.